122 miles south of Miami, Florida, lies Havana, the vibrant capital city of Cuba. The Republic of Cuba, or as the locals say, Cuba, is the largest island in the Caribbean, home to over 11 million individuals. Known for its picturesque beaches, historic cities, classic cars, cigars, and sandwiches, Cuba is an increasingly popular vacation destination. Yet each year, thousands of Cubans, young and old, build makeshift boats and rafts and attempt to sail to the southern shores of Florida to escape their communist government. As a result, many Americans see Cuba as a poor and oppressive nation. Yet one cultural aspect of Cuba that we almost never hear about? Their music and dance. The cha-cha-cha, rumba, timba salsa, and mambo are all rooted deep into the Cuban culture. The mambo, also called the salsa, was inspired by the music that the African slaves of Cuba listened to. Historically, Cuban Carnival refers to the days when slaves were able to dance through the streets to their music, traditionally on Catholic holy days. It is now an annual festival during which people are able to practice their music and dance that is no longer a religious celebration. The name salsa actually just refers to the delicious food that many people worldwide enjoy. The dance was originally called mambo, but the term salsa was used by a popular Venezuelan DJ, Danilo Fridad Escalona, during his radio show in 1966. The term is now used to refer to most kinds of Latin dance, not just the traditional Cuban mambo. The dance is 8 steps and is relatively easy to learn. Orisha is an Afro-Cuban dance style. The dance is drawn from the African religions Yoruba and Santeria. When Africans were brought to Cuba as slaves, they blended African music with Latin sounds and European beats to create an entirely new form of dance and music.
Danzón, another style of Cuban dance, was influenced by old European ballroom dancing, as well as English country dancing, the French contradanse, and the Spanish contradanza. It combines these European dance styles with traditional African influence to create a completely unique type of music and dance. The dance is more structured than other types of Latin dance, and includes frequent pauses so that the dancers may rest. It also sounds much slower than other types of Latin American music.
Timba is similar to the Cuban salsa or mambo, as they have a similar beat. Timba generally has more vocals and heavier percussion. Dancers can perform the same steps to timba as they can to salsa. While many other Latin American artists perform variations of salsa or mambo, timba is completely unique to Cuba.
Cha-cha-cha is another Cuban dance style. Named for the sound that dancers' feet make as they shuffle, the cha-cha-cha was developed as a style of dance that everyone could learn. Dancers follow a simple set of foot movement patterns while shifting their weight and moving their hips. Not only does Cuban dance draw influences from other corners of the world, Cuban music is influenced by many other cultures. Additionally, a lot of Cuban music has come to have a great effect on the American charts. There are many different unique types of Cuban music. Cuban music is one of the most important parts of the dance scene. Like Cuban dance, the music was influenced a lot by the African slaves. In particular, the religion that the slaves brought about, Santeria, a mix of African religion and the Catholic religion, influenced a lot of the music, mainly the percussion. The gods represented emotions, and the Roman Catholic saints are drum patterns. The social group that the slaves instated, the cabildos, paired their dances with music now identified as Cuban. Though the African slaves influenced a lot of the music, there is only one type of music, arito, that traces back to the three native tribes of Cuba, the Taino, Awak, and Ceremonie. Cuban decades ago would fix up instruments like the clave, congas, and bata drums to play, as well as the occasional Chinese drum brought about by Asian immigrants. One instrument that was used was a guitar, called the tres, that had an acoustic sound for the gujira. One Cuban singer, Selena Gonzalez, popularized the música campesina, which was an improvised type of music that used elements of Cuban music out of the whim to form a new type of Cuban music. The most popular form of Cuban music is the son. Son can be traced back to the Spanish farmers that inhabited the eastern part of the island and is a mix of both Spanish guitar and African rhythms. Son took on many forms over the year, but has one distinct attribute that defines the music style, the bass tone. There is a bass pulse on the background that has an anticipated bass, which comes before a downbeat every few notes. That music usually has themes of love and patriotism, and in recent times has started to develop a social and political theme. Another type of music original to Cuba is the rumba. The rumba specifically came from the dock workers in Havana and Manzatas. It is a mix of percussion and vocals that is meant for people to dance to. The tempo is slower, almost like a ballroom dance, and makes for easy dancing for both beginners and experienced dancers. The last form of music original to Cuba is trova, which was unearthed around the 1800s. Trova is played mostly by traveling people or six-person bands on the street who made their living off tips. Trova is seen as a mix of traditional Cuban song forms or rhythms like the rumba or son. A typical Cuban band of trova players consisted of guitar players, clave players, and one or two vocalists. The bands were downsized as paying for the groups of six people became too expensive, so most groups became trios. Trova lost some of its popularity when it was overshadowed by the emergence of son music, but was revived by Fidel Castro's government, along with other traditional forms of music. Overall, the music and dance of Cuba is an important aspect of the culture that has been a large part of the social scene since the country for over 200 years, since the imperialism of the nation. To fully experience the culture before leaving the island, we suggest you take a dance class. So get up on your feet and let's learn how to cha-cha-cha.
suavemente, bésame, que quiero sentir tus labios besándome otra vez. Suavemente, bésame, que quiero sentir tus labios besándome otra vez.
Suave,
bésame, bésame,
suave,
bésame otra vez.
Suave,
que quiero sentir tus labios
suave,
besándome otra vez.
Suave,
besa, besa,
suave,
bésame un poquito.
Suave,
besa, 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 bésame otro ratito. Pequeña, ella se va. Cuando te veo, comienzo a besarte. Y si te despegas, yo me despierto de ese rico sueño que me dan tus besos suavemente.
Bésame, que yo quiero sentir tus labios
besándome otra vez suavemente. Y ese coro,
bésame,
es la cosa.
Que yo quiero sentir tus labios
besándome otra vez. Bésame suavecito, sin prisa y con calma. Dame un beso bien profundo que me llegue al alma. Dame un beso más.